Hi friends, my name is Shramini. I am here to speak about the topic 7 habits of highly effective people, and I choose the habit to begin with the end in mind. If you don't make a conscious effort to visualize who you are and what you want in life, then you empower other people and circumstances to shape you and your life by default. It's about connecting again with your own uniqueness and then defining the personal, moral and ethical guidelines within which we can happily express and fulfill yourself. Begin with the end in mind means to begin each day, task or project with a clear vision of your desired direction, and then you can proactive muscles to make things happen. One of the best ways to incorporate habit 2 in your life is to develop a personal mission statement. It focuses on what you want to be and what you want to do. It's your plan for success. It reaffirms who you are and puts your goals in focus. It moves your ideas into real world. Your mission statement makes you the leader of your own life. You create your own destiny and secure the future you envision. Thank you.
Maheshwari, I'm from CS department. Now I'm going to discuss about one of the habits, putting first things first, from the book, The 7 Habits of Highly Effective People, which was written by Stephen Covey. Firstly, putting first things first means self-awareness and knowing yourself, your goals, priorities, values, roles. And putting first things first means doing important things first in life. It means being clear about your priorities and acting on them. But many people fall into the trap of getting caught up in non-important things until it becomes too late. One should be aware of their priorities in their life and act on them and achieve them. Time management plays an essential role. Time management matrix is useful to help to deal with the priorities in your life. It is divided into 4 quadrants and sorted important and non-important and urgency and non-urgency. And these can be filled with the daily routine works in our life. And the key is not to prioritize what is on our schedule, but to schedule our priorities. Thank you.
My name is Saitana from CS department. I'm going to speak about the topic of 7 habits of the highly effective people. In that, I'm speaking about synergize. In a similar sense, the exercise of all the other habits prepares us for the habit of synergize. Properly understood, synergize is the highest attitude of life. Through it, we create new, attempt the ultimate things that did not yet exist. We unleash the people greatest powers. We make a whole greater than the sum of its parts. The creative process is also the terrifying, because you don't know exactly what's going to happen or where it's going to lead. You leave the comfort zone of base camp or comfort and entirely new and unknown weirdness. You become a part finder. Once the people have been through synergy, they're not the same. It's about the quote.
Today our topic is 7 habits of highly effective people. So this book was written by Stephen R. Covey for the 20th century readers. So this book tells us about 7 habits that effective people have that makes them great. So I'm going to speak about the first habit, that is be proactive. So highly effective people are highly proactive. They take initiatives. They don't back out. These people know their limitations and strength, but they focus mainly on their strengths and don't focus more on their limitations, because that keeps him back. But they want to grow. Situations may not be under their control, but they choose to play rather than to not play and lose. Proactive people act in the land of likely. They realize what they can do and what they cannot do, but they focus that what should they do, and that makes them grow stronger. They start by changing things within them and then start changing the world. Thank you.
Hello everyone, I'm Chandana from CSC department. Today I'm going to talk about the 5th habit from 7 habits of highly effective book by Stephen Covey. The 5th habit is seek first to understand, then to be understood. Use empathetic listening to genuinely understand a person, which compels them to reciprocate the listening and take an open mind to being influenced by you. This creates an environment of caring and positive problem solving. Fifth habit is represented by 3 words by Greek philosopher. Ethos, your personal credibility. It is a trust that will inspire your emotional bank account. Pathos, it is empathetic side. It is alignment with the emotional trust of another person in communication. communication. Logos is the logic, the reasoning part of the presentation. These are the three words which represent the fifth habit from the book Seven Habits.
Hello everyone, I'm Laya and I'm here to speak about one of the habits which says put first thing first. So this particular habit surrounds moving from dependence to independence, that is self-mastery. So it talks about the difference between leadership and management. Leadership in the outside world begins with personal vision and personal leadership. It also talks about what is important and what is urgent. So there should be given some certain priority for this. The priority is like important and urgent, important and not urgent, not important and urgent, not important and not urgent. So habit three basically advises that become a leader and keep personal integrity, and whatever you say versus whatever you do.
Hello friends, this is Tanush of CSE department. I'm going to talk about the topic shorten the saw. It means the preserving and the enhance the greatest assets that you have in you. It means providing the self-renewal capacity. It means having a balanced program for self-renewal of four areas in your life. These are body, heart, mind and spiritual. And body means it comes under like exercise, beneficial of eating and taking rest. And next is heart comes under emotions. It's like relationships, connection with others. This all comes under heart. And spiritual means spending the time in nature, listening music and going for yoga or meditation, etc. And one more is and mind. It's like mental tension, like studying, writing, work. It comes under mind. As you renew yourself in each of the four areas, you create growth in your life and change. The sharpen the saw, it keeps your life fresh, peaceful and happy. And it helps to continue the other habits, other seven habits. Without this renewal, the body becomes weak and mind becomes mental, and which is other one, and heart become more emotional, and as well as the spirit make you insensitive. This all make you, because of this all, you will become more, you'll go into depressed mode. So rather than this getting into depressed mode, you can change yourself. Sharpen the saw, discuss about the self-renewal, self-care, self-respect and self-confidence. How to sharpen the saw in your personal life? Read with pleasure, not with pressure. Cook food. You will cook food because you love to cook, not because you have to cook. Go to gym. And the Stephen Conway told that if you spend at least 1 hour a day to sharpen the saw, you will succeed in your life. And I conclude it. More time remembering the sharpen the saw will get easier to your plan and to do. And whatever you choose will become the feeder. And the glass of awful and abundance of your life. Thank you.